Margrin's fire casts light in dark places.
You are from Kraytum, my boy. A remarkable city. Truly one of the most impressive we have encountered outside of our own. Many exceptional people who have joined our cause come from Kraytum. What made you decide to join our order? The gods are just, and they care for their faithful. I think that speaks to many people. Are you ready to take the oath? To spread the word of the gods to the lost and heathen?
Hello. Not a sound.
Now this I haven't seen before.
Nice and quiet.
Certainly. I'm here. Here. Yes?
Now this I haven't seen before. Nice and quiet. And the fire shows me something new.
Back you, Claude! Those hooded fiends are nigh to be trusted!
I'm here. Absolutely. Not a sound.
I can do that. That's settled.
Hail, traveler. I've been waiting on your reports. Quickly now, state your name and purpose. What company do you seek? Tell me of your labors. How do we know your purpose? And how is your oath guarded? Welcome, attendant. Tell me of your exploits. Does he wait still? Did they arrive? Your information shall be relayed. Now, for your next task. Stop him. And above all, don't let him meet her.
Yes? Certainly. Yes?
A moment, please. I feel I should explain myself. About my episode in the catacombs, there's something I should have told you earlier. I also have an awakened soul, but unlike yours, mine is a presence that shares my senses and my skin, making herself manifest at the most unwelcome times. I'm sorry. I've tried to learn to control Islemir. I've gotten stronger, but so has she. I learned to keep her a secret a very long time ago. Those with awakened souls are shunned, mistrusted. And after your experience with Meowald, I'm certain you can see why. You need to be careful. Artless, uncouth, a creature of rash impulses and feeble faculties. She wags her impertinent tongue when she should listen.
Aye, this one's fit to boil. Hard to get this gaff over anything tisn't to do with books and spill speak.
Merely an annoyance. Although... Defiance Bay is said to have an entire institution dedicated to the study and cure of soul-related ailments. Since our journeys have already brought us to the city, perhaps we could speak with someone there. Thank you. This has been a great burden.
I'm here.
Light, flame, and sound. We'll keep to ourselves. Bring back the feisty one. There's a woman can do some damage squeezing her legs together.
It isn't a parlor trick. Besides, she doesn't take orders well.
How do you do?
I don't know this castle's history, but I feel confident saying it must have seen better times.
Thank you.
My lord, you've received a letter, delivered with some urgency as it happens. I thought the messenger might swoon, poor dear. It's from Stalwart. Apparently the mayor, Renengild, has heard of your success here at Cadnua, and hopes you can be of aid to her people as well. People like you come few and far between. And in this case, I believe Renengild is correct in suggesting that your experiences here may give you an edge. It seems she's intent on gaining access to Durgan's battery. And she's offering quite the reward to anyone who can get inside. Ah, the very same. All manner of people have been trying to infiltrate the keep for years. Our own Earl was much taken with the story of the battery's fall. There are many legends concerning the battery. As the Earl told it, the dwarves fought amongst themselves, each seeking to use the battery to further his or her own ambitions. Greed and cruelty brought down the battery, and now the spirits of those same dwarves roam the halls. Whatever happened, the battery has been impenetrable ever since. A shame. I don't doubt that there are great treasures still within those halls. I should mention that, among those rumored to have answered Renengild's summons, is a certain group I believe you may have an interest in. Followers of Woodica, intent on reaching Stalwart and the Battery. I do not know what they seek there, but I thought it worth mentioning, given your interest in the ruins at Defiance Bay. Now that I've delivered Renengild's message, there is also a local matter of some concern, my lord. A mercenary band has been sighted to the northeast. I believe they mean to take Consul Hoth's tower, and I don't expect the Archmage will go quietly.
Consul Hoth's one of the greatest wizards of our generation!
The Torn Bannermen are a deadly fighting force, and Consul Hoth himself has sent many travelers to their graves. I would caution you to stay clear of the region if you do travel to the White March. It is not that I doubt your courage, my lord. But Consul Hoth alone boasts power of a different scale altogether to those foes you have faced thus far. Given more time, perhaps, you will match him. If the Bannermen succeed in their efforts, I fear they may turn their attention to Cadnua. I will keep you apprised of the situation, my lord. Little enough, I'm afraid. The Torn Bannermen are well supplied and well organized, and there are rumors that they are backed by an unknown benefactor. They have proved remarkably effective in the past, and they are certainly a threat now. A famed archmage. I am given to understand that the Brackenberry Sanitarium puts much stock in his work as regards the manipulation of the soul. His spells are widely circulated. But he is poorly regarded in many circles. Some call him a madman, or else cruel and barbarous. He must be very old by now. Perhaps that is why the Torn Bannermen believe they can best him. Safe travels, my lord.
I feel sorry for whoever has to clean up this place.